Okay, I realize some of my videos are getting kind of repetitive. It's like, let's see if this one starts. Work on another carburetor, another snowblower, but so be it. That's what I got. So I'm trying to go through these engines that I have. See if they'll all run. I'm guessing this one will. It has spark. So we'll put some juice in it and see what happens. Okay, we put some juice in it. I don't have the luxury of electric start like I do with the others. So this is first pull. Let's see what happens. Bad. Put some gas in the gas line and see what happens. Okay, we pulled off the gas line. Fill it up with gas and see what happens. So it has the throttle attached to mid speed. Okay, so let's see what happens. That's full choke, right? Okay. I'll juice back down the spark plug hole. Yeah, probably not getting any gas in the hole. But that's a good sign. That's a good running engine. You can hear it. Okay, I should be working on snowblowers, getting them ready for sale. But I just really want to work on this guy. He just sputter started. And now I got the bowl cracked. So it's kind of leaking gas, and look at that crap. It is two-stroke oil going in there, but that's, you know, it's kind of good for it. Gets the corrosion out and stuff like that. So I'm going to take down the bowl and take a look inside. Ain't that pretty? All right, and as you can see up here, well, the good thing is that the float's kind of free, but it is very dirty up there. So I'm going to spray it off with shit, meaning carb cleaner, and reassemble it and see what the difference is. Initial carb cleaning, let's see if it starts. Well, this is the last of the five engines, and it doesn't have a pull start, and I wanted to see if this one at least sparked. It definitely was a snowblower machine, but it looks pretty small, like maybe 4 horse, 5, I don't know. The numbers are right where they put the electric start, and it also has all that kind of belts, you know, two-stage, two-shaft belt engine. So I don't know, but just check for spark. Had a smaller spark plug than the other ones, and I don't see any spark. So this is the only one that you know, doesn't spark or run. All the other ones I've gotten running, so it's just this one, and no real need to get it going either. So I just want to know the state of them all before I, you know, so I know what I got basically. Okay, let's see what happens with the electric start. This is always fun, you know, don't know what's going to happen. And I'm going to turn out the light so maybe we can see spark. If we won't, who knows. Oh no, that Bendix doesn't want to pop out. Okay. So a little starter motor maintenance is necessary. But like I said, I might just put this one aside. I don't really have a need for it right now. All right, so it's really cold and damp out this morning. It's 40 degrees and raining, or still drizzly. I think it's going to clear up a little bit. So I figured I'd get back into this thing, just curiously pull off that shroud and see if I can fix the pull start. Okay, now to get this shroud off, we had to take the electric start off too, which was one, two, three bolts. Oh, there goes a little
doohickey.
This holds the gas tank on. Okay, now we'll see if we can pop off the shroud. I gotta put the camera down, you can have a look. What kind of nest is under this thing? Okay, we had to pull off the primer line. And the critters aren't too bad. There are a couple of big spiders that were in here. Poor things, they've lost their home now. Might even shut this outside for a little while and see if maybe they go away. Okay, there's just a coil on this one, which is kind of nice, no points. But I have no spark, so. But we'll also haven't looked to see what kind of shape the rope is in here, but that's next. Well, I haven't encountered a pull start like this before. What a piece of shit. They got like one screw there that I guess you take out and pop this thing off. Because, I don't know, you can't even see the rope or anything. It may be easier than I think, but I don't know. Tecumseh, it seems like the newer they got, the cheesier they got. So all it is. And here's that electric start with the Bendix that's kind of stuck. We'll get some lube on that and it'll probably loosen up and be good. I wish I could put this on a larger size Tecumseh, but I don't know if it will work or not. But we'll get some lube on it anyway. I'm gonna see if I can still get a spark out of this thing. Okay, so no spark so far. And I'm looking down here at the flywheel and okay. You can see the nut in there. Let me try to get the light over here a little better. Okay, now you can see it. The nut in there doesn't look like it's, you know, all the way home. So something really funky's going on here. I think I'm gonna have to pull off that flywheel and take a look. Sorry, bud. You and your friends now gotta go. We'll probably want to go. Sorry. We'll take them outside. So there's this nylon spacer here. I'm not familiar with this leg at all. Which I guess would prevent the flywheel from going on any further. Very odd. But the flywheel did line up with the coil, so heck knows. So with or without that nylon spacer, that's as far as the flywheel will go in. You can just see the beginning of the threads there. So I guess this is correct, although it's really strange. Well, I'm gonna undo this one screw here and see if we can get this thing off. I think I do remember doing one of these in the past. I'll show you when I get this the screw out and it off. Well, that came off easy enough. Hopefully my spider friends have gone. Okay, gotta dig a little deeper. Okay, this centerpiece is just kind of pressed on there. And so I'm kind of looking for the beginning of the rope to pull through the hole. Now I get some spring tension on it before I pull it through. But I keep winding it around. I think that looks like it, but it just isn't coming loose. But we'll keep poking at it until we do get it loose. How about that? Oh, a white spider. I got white and black spiders. We've got equality here. How nice. Okay, that's all the rope that was in there. What I thought was the beginning of the rope was one of these spider nests. So we need a new rope. And we'll wind it up. And I'll see if I can find a handle. I think I got one. Okay, I got this thing back wound this way, counterclockwise. As far as it can go, the rope's got to go where? Right here, and it's got to come out here. So I'm going to thread it in. I'm going to take, I got this nice new recoil rope, and I'm going to burn the end so that it can poke it out here and then out there. I'm a baby on camera here. Poke in here and then out there, and then we'll look for a handle. Say, that is one really small rope hole there. So I'm not quite sure how I'm going to get the rope through it, to tell you the truth. I usually go in this way, but since I have this thing wound tight and it's not quite meeting up, I wanted to go through this way, but I don't know. I'm going to work out this one, I think. I'm going to try it like this. We put a wire through the rope, and we're going to put a little piece of tape on it so that it'll hopefully smoothly go through the hole. Hooray! Yeah, that was easy. Okay, a simple half hitch on both ends. I put a washer underneath that. Just because they usually sometimes pull through the rubber. It's a cheesy handle, but it will indeed work. Well, it should work. I gotta see if I can find some more sheet metal screws like that, because there aren't any others. This, you know, I'm bitching about it, but in a way, you know, you can take it off pretty easy to fix it. Although I did want to take off the whole shroud to see if there was a nest or whatever underneath it. Put a couple more sheet metal screws and we'll be able to put this back on. Then we'll go for a sputter. Okay, I put the shroud back on. This little weird piece of extra metal was bent and giving me a hard time, and I wasn't realizing like why I couldn't get the shroud on, but that was the reason. So it's kind of mangled up there. I'll bend it back. But we got everything on. I did want to try to clean off and see what size engine this was, but it looks like it is, can you read that? I can barely read it, like 14 some or other. When you see a number like that, I was told it's from Sears and Roebuck, that for their Craftsman snowblowers, they'd put on their own serial numbers instead of the Tecumseh number. So I'm going to see if I can find a way to find out what exactly this engine is for horsepower. All right, spark. Okay, if I had to bet on it, I'd bet the house on it that this is going to start, or sputter, anyway. Let's see. First pull. Good engine. Okay, so that kind of concludes the going through all the engines, the five engines that I got, that I acquired. They're all good. They all seem like they're going to run and can be used for various projects, snowblowers, etc. Okay, going to get some lunch, and after that, back outside into the cold and see what we can fix. Well, we're back on the Craftsman 826 this morning. That tire still looked like it was needing some help, so I put some slime in it, some air. The other tires have been pretty good with the slime. They've been coming back. But as I was doing that, the carb started leaking. Jesus. So I pulled off the bowl and I looked at it. And then I looked in the tank. I don't know if you'd be able to see this. Well, it looks like a lot of crap in there. So I'm going to pull the tank off and try to give it a clean if I can. Well, where we left off with the snow champ was we're going to create a kill wire. I can't see a thing. I'm in the sun. I'm assuming you can see that wire. And I want to attach that to this post here. Then I want to run this post off to, I'd love to put one of those switches in here that's missing. Or if not, I'll put a toggle switch in the housing that goes over the carburetor. Okay, I'm still battling with this kill switch bullshit. And I took out of the housing here the place where I had a key switch, because I didn't have a key for it anyway, although it's just a chunk of plastic that you jam in there. And I took the switch, which is this right here, and hitched that up where you should, and that wire is going to the coil. And when you bring down the throttle, grounds it out. So that really should work, but the connection to the coil just isn't there. It's brand new wire, brand new. Everything's cleaned off. It's just screwy. I guess it does work. Not bad.